fire burns. But it can also renew. Prescribe fire is a tool that recreates natural, low-intensity fire, clearing out readily available vegetation, the fuel that could feed rapidly spreading and devastating wildfires, removing a very real threat to firefighters and communities. And helping the forest repair itself, becoming stronger, healthier, and more fire resilient.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Welcome to Turkey Tracks RX. My name is Mike Wicks. We're gonna go ahead and get the briefing started.
For these firefighters on this crisp fall morning, the mission is simple.
That would encompass 497 acres if we take that today. That is our goal. If it happens, great. If it doesn't happen, that's also great. The goal is to be safe out here.
Southwest.
Using prescribed fire to reduce hazardous vegetation or fuel that could feed a high-intensity devastating wildfire, threatening surrounding communities and infrastructure.
The Turkey Tracks area is a user-created recreational target shooting area on the Pike National Forest, Pikes Peak Ranger District. This area is located in the burn scar from the Hayman fire in 2002.
While it's been two decades since the Hayman fire, you only have to look up to see the sobering reminder of what a large-scale wildfire can do to the landscape.
It began under the most extreme conditions that we could possibly have. Humidity was about 5%. Winds were very, very strong, 25, 30 miles an hour with gusts much higher. And the fire ran 17 miles in the first day.
The Hayman had plenty of fuel, and like dozens of forests and millions of acres all across the West, a century of fire suppression has led to forest overstocking, creating more to burn.
If you remove fire from a forest for about a century, like we have been doing, what happens is a lot of regeneration comes in, small trees seed in and they begin to grow. The forest becomes denser and denser with more regeneration and more trees. The fuels, the dead woody fuels and the duff and the litter builds up to the point when we have landscapes for tens of miles in any direction that have a tremendous amount of fuel and very, very overstocked forest, very, very dense forest. And this means that when fires do start and when fires do escape fire suppression efforts, then they have a huge amount of fuel to consume for tens of miles in any direction.
Creating breaks in the vegetation takes fuel from a potential wildfire, and even one prescribed burn could be key to protecting lives and property. When the Hayman fire came through here, it jumped Highway 67 and simply seemed unstoppable until this part of the fire ran up against the edge of a prescribed burn from the year before.
It was called the Polhamis prescribed burn. The remarkable thing about that is its effect on the Hayman fire was that the Hayman fire, when it hit the edge of that, it pretty much stopped. So one thing we learned from the Hayman fire study, as well as many other studies throughout the West, is how important prescribed burning is. There really is no substitute for prescribed burning or for fire itself to come through and to clean up a lot of the duff and the litter, the dead and down woody fuels, to kill small trees that would otherwise grow up and make a very dense forest that would be easily destroyed by fire.
Managing the forest means managing risk and recreating natural, low-intensity fire with prescribed fire not only greatly lowers the potential for large-scale wildfire, but it is also literally a prescription for what ails our forests. Clearing out undergrowth, creating open areas, and ultimately more resilient and healthy forests.
One thing about these fire-dependent ecosystems that we have in the West is that fire is inevitable. It's going to happen. 100% chance that fire will visit pretty much every forest that we have. The only choices that we really have then are when to have it and what kind to have. Prescribed fire is the only alternative to this, really, and that is to pick the time and the place and the conditions under which we do those burns. If we don't do those things, the consequence is going to be extreme wildfire. And we already know what that looks like on landscapes here in Colorado. The Hayman fire, the Cimarron Peak fire, the East Troublesome fire, all of these fires are burning across landscapes that haven't had fire influences for nearly a century.
The overall scope of implementing this prescribed fire is to create a more fire resilient landscape that's going to help to reduce fuel loading, to provide for firefighter safety, and to help protect our communities around us.